What is Exhibit 1011?
This is a chapter from a book that I've relied on that I've used in teaching as an example of, maybe I should say what the book is. So this is a chapter from a book that was published in the 60s, late 60s. It was a very popular book. It was called Everything You Ever Wanted to Know About Sex But Were Afraid to Ask. It was very, very popular. It was published in many, I have a hardcover edition from, that is the 17th edition of this book, and it was published in 1969. And I personally remember the book. So in this book, there are different chapters that aim to educate the public about different issues concerning sexuality. And this particular chapter is concerning male homosexuality.
And this is a book that had wide distribution?
Absolutely.
Could we put up demonstrative 2, please?
I'm going to ask you about this, but what I would like to do is just read the text into the record so it's clear what you're addressing.
May I explain something about this?
Of course.
I'm sorry. So the book is written in question and answer format. And basically the author goes through explaining sexual issues as if there's a question that somebody is asking him about his opinion about various sexual issues, then he provides the answer. So this is an excerpt of one of those questions and answers.
Okay. So the question is posed. What about all the homosexuals who live together happily for years? And the answer is, what about them? They are mighty rare birds among the homosexual flock. Moreover, the happy part remains to be seen. The bitterest argument between husband and wife is a passionate love sonnet compared with a dialogue between a butch and his queen. Live together? Yes. Happily? Hardly.
Is this text from this book an example of the stigma that you're talking about, sir?
Yes. I think this is a very dramatic experience of what I was referring to, where, in this case, an educational book portrays the relationship between, in this case, gay men as, with great disrespect, I would say ridicule and contempt. So that was the kind of one example of what I was referring to.
At what stage in life does stigma begin to affect gay men and lesbians?
Stigma really affects all people in society because it's a social norm, if you will. It is something that we all in society learn from a very young age. It affects gay and lesbians, particular stigma affects gay men and lesbians in a particular way, because it is about something that is very pertinent to how they think about who they are. In my mind, this kind of stigma or other stereotypes are very impactful, especially at the younger age, and in particular in the time of life where gay men and lesbians, usually during youth, either realize or recognize or know that they're gay, and begin to try to understand what that means to them. And of course, the most available reference that they would have is the kind of thing that they've learned over their lifetime, over their childhood, socialization that we've all been exposed to. So this affects everybody, but certainly it affects in a very strong way somebody who is maybe coming out and realizing that he or she is gay, and that's what they might believe is what's in line for them.